Cecilia had great time in Jordan last month, and she's here to share her experience with you. So if you have some questions about volunteering, about her time there, please write the questions here and we will answer, okay? Let's start.
Great, let's do it. Yeah, absolutely.
So, Julia, first we want to know, what motivated you to seek this kind of experience?
Okay, well, so back to going Germany, Jordan. I am from Germany originally, but I study in London at the University of Westminster. Well, I did study, I'm finishing now, 3 years, politics and international relations. And what motivated me, well, I guess throughout my course of studying politics and IR, I learned a lot more about the Middle East and other cultures and countries which are not in the West where I grew up in general. So when the university was offering to go on the trip to Jordan with the Changing Lives program, I thought this would be the perfect opportunity to round up my experience here at university and actually go myself and see a different culture, see a country, namely Jordan, which I would never visit with my friends or family just for a holiday trip. And also because the program seemed very appealing, because one of the things was cultural exchange, to learn more about Jordan, the people, again the culture. And the other aspect was to go volunteering as well. So we had many projects planned to go work in a refugee camp, to go teach children English, to go do some planting work in the botanical gardens of Amman. And all those things, they were very appealing and very insightful for me to apply for the program. The whole people, whoever we met on the way, everybody was super welcoming, whether in English or in Arabic, they would greet us, they would, you know, offer us in to come and see what's happening in the shops and on the markets. The first day we went, again, in this more artsy area, we went to a restaurant, a non-profit organization that cooks, well, that is based on volunteers and donations, and the people there, they are cooking for those who can't afford a good meal.
What is the name of this restaurant?
SVT restaurant, in near Jeddah in Amman. We have the information on our Instagram as well. If you want to check out our Instagram page, there is a video about every single day of what I did in Jordan, and on the first one there is the whole description of the name. So yeah, we went and participated there, to give some donations, but then also actively participate in the cooking and engage with the local people there. And it was a very beautiful experience to talk to the volunteers, you know, women from Amman, locals, but then also we met some American volunteers who work there.
Julia, doing conversations with people from other countries, for instance, you met people from Iraq. What impressed you? What did you learn with that?
Okay, so a lot. That's all I can say for sure. I learned a lot. We were joined, so the University of Westminster students were joined by 3 students from Iraq, and also we were welcomed by the Middle East University students from Jordan, amongst whom there was a Palestinian friend as well, and also another Iraqi girl. And yeah, I just have to say that right now, we became really, really good friends with them in the end, which was beautiful. I mean, now that I can go back to Germany next week and tell my friends at home I have friends from Iraq, that is something incredible.
Yes.
That not everybody can say, right? That was definitely very, very, very cool experience. But in terms of learning, I guess, you know, we exchanged a lot of thoughts and experiences about not only our cultures, but also the ways in which we grew up. You know, talking to the girls, for example, we would talk about, you know, many topics, such as having boyfriends, or, you know, like marriage, or going out, all those things, and compare, and just, you know, exchange. And that was, although we saw quite a few differences that was done in a very respectful manner, in a very understanding manner, and that was really nice. From the Iraqis, they told us a lot about their own, their homeland. They told us a lot about Iraq, how, you know, it is, there's no war anymore, right? So it's safe to go now. So we were supposed to go and teach children from the age of, well, let's say between 12 and 16, if I'm not wrong, to teach them English. So we had all prepared a few like games and ideas on how to teach them a few new words, grammar, expressions, in a very fun manner. And when we arrived there, we were greeted by them so nicely and so warmly. They would like sing songs for us and provide us with lunch as well, which was really nice. And we did those games with them, we did those teaching lessons with them, and I was absolutely amazed about their level of English, which was so high. Again, I remember I went to a public school in Germany, and we have English from, I think, second grade, first grade, so like from a very young age, and my level of English when I was 15 was not nearly as high as the level of English of those children there. And we talked to the volunteers there and the teachers there, and they had taught them what they knew without ever having traveled to an English-speaking country before. So basically all like they knew and they passed on was knowledge about the language that they acquired from YouTube or books or you know, just like online programs. So it was so incredible to see how much like teaching can be done, how much you can pass on to somebody with little resources in that sense, or like opportunities. And again, we did talk a lot to those kids, to those volunteers, teachers, whether it was, you know, again about English, whether it was about our country, whether it was about football, dancing, you know, our aspirations for the future. I literally feel like we learned so much more from them than we could actually have taught them, which was incredibly emotional, but also something, you know, I will never forget again, you know.
What is the difference between Julia before Jordan and Julia today?
I would definitely, okay, you know, it's funny because the program that we went on is called Changing Lives Program. And literally me and my friends, or like all of us who went there, we thought, okay, we're going to learn about the culture, but we're going to volunteer and teach people, help people, and change their lives. And I feel like our lives have been changed so much more than we would ever be able to, you know, like have an impact on anybody else. We've learned, again, a lot about the culture. We've learned a lot about life in Jordan. I am way more open to the idea of traveling some more, you know, in neighboring countries. Again, Iraq is something that I have in mind right now, even like Lebanon, different countries in the area. I want to go back to Jordan again and, you know, explore it some more. I guess, yeah, I have just become way more open to the idea that it is safe to go and that it is important to take an opportunity when you get it and go travel, go explore other parts of the world and open your eyes, open your horizon and be open to, yeah, like different impressions and other people as well.
You can take a look at our Instagram account because Julia uploaded daily videos there, so you can see her, you can follow her journey in full details on our Instagram account. And as we have said, it is changing life programs, and besides changing those people affected by violence lives, it changes your life as well.
Absolutely.
Yes, and that's the idea of launching the social media campaign My Volunteer Journey. Yeah. Because we want to encourage you to share pictures of you volunteer on our Instagram account, because it is of main importance to share this experience with the whole world. Because besides contributing with local communities, you are also deconstructing some ideas that have been responsible for reproducing violence for generations. If you had this experience of volunteering before, please share a picture of you on Instagram with the hashtag MyVolunteerJourney. Let's heal the world!
Thank you guys for your attention.